Hey, this is Mike. Before I get started, please hit the subscribe button. I know you will not be disappointed. I have hundreds of videos like this, and I'm trying to help you out, so please hit the subscribe button to help me out. So anyways, I'm here at East Coast Honda in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, and they just happen to have the new 2016 HR-V that everybody's talking about. So I rushed on down here to check it out myself and to show it to you guys. So here it is. Now this one has the navigation and has some pretty cool upgrades, has the aluminum wheels and sunroof, and it looks really sharp. Now Honda has really put together a really awesome small crossover SUV. It's kind of a really small SUV. And that's exactly the kind of car I like. I don't like big cars myself, and a lot of people kind of, you know, they just want something to get around in, but has excellent room. So you can see this one is not a huge boatmobile, but when you get inside, it just feels so comfortable, and it has a lot of room for even for the backseat drivers. So here in the front, you can see it has the reflector halogen headlights and fog lights. And it has a pretty interesting design to it that I guess it has some sportiness to it, but it's not too outlandish. It just has a really classy, neat design. That's the only way I could describe it. So the alloy wheels are painted silver in this case, and they do have 17-inch Michelin tires. It does have the four-wheel disc brakes. You can see the front and the back there. Give you a little bit of a walk around here. Since this is a new car, you probably haven't seen any of these on the road yet. That's why you're watching this video, to check it out, see if it's something you're interested in buying. By the way, John Vincent is a pretty cool dude here. He works at East Coast Honda. And he's somebody you can talk to and get one of these, and he will deliver it to your house anywhere in the United States. Isn't that cool? Alright, so you've looked at the outside. Let's start looking at the inside. Alrighty, there's the inside of the passenger door, and pretty much everything's soft to the touch here. Soft, soft, does have some contrast stitching here. You got a place to put a bottle. Water bottle or something there. You do have manual seats. This one has leather with some perforated leather trim. Very comfortable seats. You gotta really drive this car to see what I'm talking about. Has plenty of legroom. Look at all that legroom. Let's take a look here at the glove compartment. Pretty standard size. You know, not too big, not too small. It's what you would expect in a vehicle this size. Now it has these little pockets here. So like say when you get in a vehicle, you always have something in your hand, keys or cell phone or something in your hand, bottle. So you can put your stuff down here. You can put stuff in here. Really cool place here for your cell phone right there. And it kind of stops it from sliding too far down. You can put it like that. Plus there's some connectivity here too as well. And it's interesting. It has a power supply, 12 volt, it has two USB ports, but look at there, it has an HDMI. You can actually play videos, HD videos, up to 720p videos on the little screen here, as long as you're in park. Isn't that cool with the HDMI input? I've never seen that before, on that style anyway. All right, let's continue on. I like the way they have those racks there on the top, those aluminum racks, kind of outlines the shape of the vehicle a little bit better. Alrighty, let's take a look at the back. Here's the inside of the back door. Same soft to the touch everything, contrast stitching, big speaker, and there's the back seats. And like I was saying, you've got plenty of room. Look at, you got plenty of headroom. The leg room is substantial, not to mention the seat is off the floor quite a bit. So your knees are not sticking up in the air like some vehicles. So this is a really good option for, you know, not a big SUV, but having plenty of room. So, and also these seats will fold down. But before I show you that, you do have a power outlet back here and a cup holder for the backseat drivers. So let's go ahead and fold this down. So you can see it folds completely flat and it effectively doubles your cargo capacity, and you have the ability to have a combination of passenger and cargos, you know, just a combination of either one. So let's say you've got somebody sitting there, but then you have this long box here, or you can have somebody, you know, let's say you have a wider box, you can have this seat up and those seats down, and that way you have, you know, that whole combination there. Because you never know what you're going to buy and you need to fit it in your car. So it's good to have that flexibility. All right, let's check out those tail lights there. You got the LEDs and then you have the reflectors over here. That's pretty neat. So at any time you have any questions or comments, please start commenting in the comment section. Really want to have as much information in this video and in the comment section as possible for everybody to benefit from. Okay, so here's the back of the car, and you can see it does have like this cargo mat in place. It says HRV, and it's dished. I don't know how to explain it. It's recessed to where it'll catch sand or dirt or whatever. And so like if you go to the beach and you have sandy clothes or towels or whatever, you can throw it in there and it's not gonna, you know, spill over in the carpet. You're actually gonna be able to catch it in there, and then you can take this mat out and clean it out easier. So underneath here is a little storage compartment, and then underneath that is your spare tire. So, and this vehicle does have a spare tire. You got to watch out because a lot of new cars do not come with a spare tire. So you just want to make sure that you're aware if you have a spare tire or not. If you don't, just make sure you know that in advance. You don't want to find out that you don't have a spare tire on a Saturday night driving out of town, that kind of thing. So let's go ahead and close it down. We also want to show you, it does have this roof mount spoiler here, which is not just to be cool, but it also adds to the aerodynamics of the vehicle. So you can have a decent coefficient of drag. And if you don't know what that is, I'm gonna have to have Matt explain it. The engineer Matt will have to make a video on the coefficient of drag. Okay, so the key is here, and it's just, this one in particular just has a key fob. So as long as I have this in my pocket or in my purse or whatever, I can have it, you know, within a few feet of the vehicle, and I can lock and unlock the doors. So locking the doors, you push this button. So now it'll lock. But if I want to get in the vehicle, all I have to do is put my hand behind the handle here. It senses the key. It senses my hand. That's why they call it a proximity key, because it's, as long as it's within a certain proximity, it will be sensed by the vehicle and you can actually use the vehicle. It knows you're safe and it lets you in. All right, so let's go ahead and open up the fuel door. I want to show you in there. There's the fuel door, there's the fuel cap. You notice it's angled a little bit, so you're standing here, you can pump the gas, and you know, it's a more of a comfortable position. And when you undo the cap, it does have a little place to hang it right here. It even says cap, it lets you know, because you don't want it hanging down by its plastic string and scratching your front, your shiny paint here. So it does have a little neat place to put the cap, and I like the way it's lockable, so that way it keeps people out. Okay, let's look under the hood. Here's the latch here. .8-liter VTEC engine. So opening up the hood, is there's the Honda symbol there. You just reach in, just right above it, it's a little bit to the left of it, and there's a handle here, and you just move it to the right. See it there? All right, 1.8 liter iVTEC engine. I love the VTEC Honda engine. It gets really good gas mileage, and it will really surprise you with the power and efficiency this vehicle has. Now, you'll notice one thing. It doesn't have a plastic cover over the engine. You get to actually see the engine, and that makes me so happy. I love to see the engine when I lift the hood. The plastic covers, I do not care to see. So thank you, Honda, for allowing me to see an engine. All right, say goodbye to the 1.8 liter. And let's say hello to the inside of the vehicle. All right, here we are on the inside. And wow, this is a really neat vehicle. You can see I have plenty of knee room and leg room. The seat goes even back further. So let's start here on the driver's door. And you can see it has the speaker there and also power windows, power door locks. You do have the ability to lock out the power windows if you want to, so you don't, people don't roll up and down the windows. And to adjust your side mirrors, you just have to pick a side, left or right, and then use this little pad here to adjust the mirror. And then once you get done, you want to put it back in the center to avoid, you know, accidentally messing up the mirrors that you just adjusted. All right, so over here is, you have the kind of eco mode, pushing that button. That tail gives a little green thing that pops up there. That tells the car that you want to get the best gas mileage possible, and you're not that concerned about the performance. So, you know, you're just kind of letting the car know that, and it will just kind of adjust accordingly. Your performance will be cut back a little bit, and the shift points will be a little bit faster, and it's not going to hold out for the power band on every single shift. So that's what the economy thing there does. Your traction control, you can turn that off. Default is always on, but if you need to spin tires, especially if you're stuck or something like that, you go ahead and turn that off, and it'll give you full control over spinning tires and all that stuff. So this button here is related to your tire pressure monitoring system. So if you're driving around and your tire pressure light comes on, then you know that means that one of your tires, at least one of your tires, is low on air. So you want to go ahead and put air in, fix the leak or whatever, and when you get done with it, you need to reset the tire pressure monitoring system. You push and hold this button. Same thing if you rotate your tires. You push and hold that button, and it resets it, and then the light will go off, and then you're good to go. And then, you know, until something happens again, or you rotate your tires. So that's how you reset the tire pressure monitoring system with that button there. It's not something you do all the time, but it is, you know, easy to get to when you do have to do it. Alrighty, let's take a look at the steering wheel. The steering wheel is leather wrapped with black leather. It has hand stitched on the inside. Very comfortable and high quality feeling. The leather is very tight, and there's a pretty good thickness to the steering wheel. And then you have that shiny plastic, and check this out, these little holes here. It actually goes all the way through. That's pretty neat. So here on the steering wheel, there's, you know, quite a few buttons. And on the right side is your cruise control. You just have to make sure it's turned on, and then you can set it, adjust your speed, and cancel it there. Very simple. It's been like that for a long time. So down here is your phone buttons and also your voice recognition button. So basically, once you pair your phone with the Bluetooth system, you can send and receive calls using these buttons. You're driving along, and all of a sudden the radio dims out, and if your fan's blowing, you know, the air conditioning's blowing real loud, it'll dim out as well, and it'll start ringing through the system. To answer it, you just push this button and you say hello, and you talk to the person on the other end. You have a conversation, and when you're done, you just push this button to hang up. Now, that's to receive a call. Now, if you want to make a call, you use this button here. This is the voice recognition system. You push that button and you say, call John Smith, or whoever happens to be in your phone book. You just have to say it the way it's spelled in your phone book. So if it's abbreviated, you have to say it that way, or to correct it in your phone book.
So there's your voice recognition. Now there's other things that you can do with the voice recognition besides make phone calls. You can also, you know, adjust, go to a certain place on the navigation. There's lots of different commands, and it'll actually step you through the different commands if you're not familiar with it once you start using it. And it does recognize your voice very well, and it gets better every time you use it because it adapts itself to your voice. So really cool there. Cool. Not only is this cool and it's convenient, but it's also an extremely good safety feature. So I highly recommend using it, getting a vehicle that has Bluetooth and voice recognition, and use those features because it keeps your eyes on the road, hands on the wheel, and you're staying productive at the same time. So we all need to stay productive, but we don't want to compromise our safety in order to do so, or other people's safety for sure. All right, so these buttons here on the left side of the steering wheel correspond with the screen over here. So this is your volume button up and down. You can change through stations or tracks here. You can cycle through different menu systems with these buttons, and then you can change the source like AM, FM, satellite radio, USB, all that stuff with that button. So on the back of the steering wheel, you actually have paddle shifters right here and here. Now this one has a CVT transmission, but it simulates, you know, it has gear ratios just like any other transmission, and so you can, you know, manually shift through the gear ratios in sport mode to really have control over the car. And it's also useful if you're going downhill and you need to downshift. So that's pretty cool, the paddle shifters. So here on the left side is your headlights. You can go to, you know, parking lights. There's off parking lights, automatic, which is great. It automatically turns on and off. You don't have to worry about it. Or if you just want to manually turn them on. Automatic is awesome. Also, your fog lights, you can turn those on and off right there. On the right side is your windshield wipers and stuff there. And also, on the end of this, right here, is a button that you can push, and it will give you a camera view of the right side of the vehicle. So, this is pretty cool because if you just need to see to the right, like basically in your blind spot, right back there in that area, you just push that button and it quickly, and also kind of clues you in here which direction you're facing. You just push that button and you can see right there in your blind spot on your far side. You don't even have to, you know, break your neck trying to look over there. And it's just easy, like your hand's still on the wheel and you push the button. Push it again and it goes away. Also, if you turn your turn signal on, it'll also do that. Really, really cool features there. And I apologize for the air conditioning being on, but it is extremely hot today. And we will get to that right now. Here's the gauges. And you can see, really easy to read. Really crisp, black and white, simple gauges to look at. Your RPMs are there to the left, speedometer there front and center, and then you've got some different information there, including your average miles per gallon, and your real-time miles per gallon will fluctuate as you're driving right there in front of you, right in this area, right there. And then you see a clock, how many miles the vehicle has on it. Your gas gauge is down here, and look at that, 105 degrees. Like I said, it is hot today. So that's why I got the air conditioner on. But look at those gauges, I mean, and it's pretty cool. They all kind of disappear when I turn the vehicle off. Turn it back on so you can see the whole cycle there, and it just illuminates, come to life. Alrighty. So now, let's go over here. There's the Honda Link starting back up since I restarted the vehicle. There's your four-way flashers. There's your start button. And all it takes is just putting your foot on the brake and pushing the start button. That's all you have to do. As long as the key's in the vehicle, which it is right there, they kind of made a little spot here. All right, so let's check out this touchscreen. You notice there's no physical buttons other than this retro CD player. That's like a vintage style CD player up there. I'm not sure why they keep adding it to the vehicles. It's been obsolete for years, but people still use CD players, so they put it in there for people. So that's, I guess that's good. So anyways, you do have some physical buttons up there, but the rest of them are just basically touchscreen.
So let me hit the home button to show you. Now you'll notice these buttons here on the left will appear and disappear depending on if you can actually touch them in that, you know, in that particular screen. So right now, let's go here, and it has your, this is your home screen, and it has these different icons to go into your main features of the system. So let's go into the navigation. So now when I push navigation, you'll notice you have this button here pops up, and this button here pops up, and so here's the map, and the map is very crisp, easy to see. It's different, lots of different colors. Really satisfied with the image quality of the screen, especially with this map. All right, so let's go back out of that by pushing the home. Let's go to phone. Of course, it's going to ask me to pair a phone, but once you pair your phone, you can have your phone book, you can have call history, you can speed dial people, and all that good stuff. So, you know, the phone system, not only with the voice recognition, but you can also control it here on the screen. So let's go back home. Let's hit the information screen, and look at there. You have the clock, but also you can change the background. You notice East Coast Honda has put their wallpaper there, so you can actually have like a picture there, whatever you want, with the clock over it. Isn't that cool? All right, let's go to audio, and this is basically, you know, AM, FM, satellite radio, stuff like that. Let's hit source so you can see all the different things. Look at that. AM, FM, satellite radio, CD, USB, iPod, Pandora, which that's will go through your cell phone. Same thing with AHA, and there's, of course, your cell phone there. And then Bluetooth, like any kind of Bluetooth audio device. And there's that HDMI port button there, so you can actually watch stuff on the screen. Which the image quality is, I mean, the clarity of the screen looks like it'll be fun to watch. I guess, like, if you were to, you know, have some home videos or whatever, you just do some video with your kids or whatever, and you want to plug it in and check it out on the screen before you get home, that's perfectly capable of doing that. All right, so let's go back home. So you got settings here, your navigation, you know, your phone, your clock info, all that stuff you can change the way you want. And then this is where you connect to your cell phone, your Bluetooth device, and you can play, like, say you can play through those different apps like AHA and Pandora, that kind of stuff. All right, so there's the kind of the main features there with the touchscreen in this vehicle. And you notice it's all sleek. You can easily clean it. There's no buttons getting in the way other than the ones on top. You know, regular buttons like this type of button can get dirt and all that stuff around in it. And when you're cleaning it, it just pushes it down in the cracks. And, you know, and then you get all mad and rage quit. But with the smooth screen like this, you just wipe it down and you're good to go. It looks brand new again. And the same principle applies down here with your climate control. You have the same type of soft touch buttons that's completely easy to use and colorful, well, easily seen, I guess, because of the contrast, and also, you know, you can clean it off. So you do have the temperature here. You do have heated seats here in the front too as well. See, heated seats. You can change your fan speed like that. You push this is mode, it changes where you want the air to blow, like that. And then you can always put it on automatic and just set your temperature and roll with it. But you can also, you know, change all these things. So you can have the front and rear defrosters. Now when you turn on the rear defrosters, you'll notice it has this thing here that's showing you that the side mirror defrosters will also turn on simultaneously with the rear defroster. Alright, so here's the shifter. And you notice there's a little thing behind the shifter. It looks like a perfect place to put the key, and that's probably why they designed it that way. That's why I put the key immediately in there when I got in. But here's the shifter. Let me go ahead and put it in reverse so you can see the backup camera pop up. And the backup camera is a little bit different from, you know, the run-of-the-mill camera. It has different views. So you can get a super wide shot, you know, a little bit less wide, and then more straight down behind you. So It's a little bit harder to get some context in this picture. I guess if, like, say, if there was something that more than what we're looking at now, you can kind of understand where this is actually aiming. But you do have the ability to change the view, which is really cool. And the less wide the camera is, the less distorted is. You notice these cars are distorted around the edges because it's a very wide angle view. And that's the reason for the lines. You see these lines, they're actually turning as I turn the steering wheel. I'm turning the steering wheel now, and it's turning to let me know which direction I'm gonna go. But also, it tells me about the approximate width of the vehicle as I back up. Plus, it has kind of guidelines here. So you don't wanna really get too close. You see this line here? That's pretty much as close as you wanna go. Because it may not look like there's a lot of space there, but it's really just a matter of inches. Down here would be more like feet, pretty far away. But right up here, since this is a distorted lens, and you know, it's a wide angle lens, and all wide angle lenses are distorted in this way. It's like a fisheye lens. So basically they're just trying to help you out here with this line to let you know, hey, just don't go any closer than that, because that's really close already. All right, so let's continue down with the shifter. There's neutral. And let's go down here to drive. Now that's your normal drive position. You just put it in drive and you're good to go, and you drive around, and it'll always, since it's a CVT, it's gonna stay in the right gear ratio all the time. So now if you wanna use the paddle shifters, all you have to do is put it right down here in sport mode and you're shifting away. So right now it says sport right there, or it has the S for sport. So I'm gonna push the plus here on the steering wheel. And you can see this gives me an M, which is manual, and I can switch through the gears. It's not going to let me go out of first gear because I'm just sitting still. But you can also push and hold, like say, it's only going to that manual mode because I pushed the button. If I want to go back into just regular drive mode, I can push and hold the right button, and it'll go back into automatic sport mode. So you don't always have to use the paddle shifters. I want to make sure that's clear. The paddle shifters are optional. So putting it in sport mode is still automatic until you start messing with the paddle shifters. Then it'll go into that manual mode. Also, the sport mode is kind of the opposite of this green button over here. Instead of telling the vehicle that you want gas mileage, it's telling the vehicle that you want all the horsepower, all the performance that this car has. You want everything this car has as far as performance wise, and you don't care about gas mileage right now. So that's what this, you know, the sport mode is pretty much going to enable. Also, it's going to stiffen up the steering wheel. I think it feels like it might stiffen up that. It's hard to really tell. I can't really tell. Some vehicles stiffen up the steering wheel. It's hard to really tell. I don't know what to tell you there. It doesn't feel any difference there. All right, so here's your parking brake. It is a electric parking brake. So all you have to do is pull up on it to engage it, and it'll say park there. And to disengage it, you just push it down, and you can actually feel the pedal move if you have your foot on it, whether it's on or off. Brake hold is really neat. That's something I've never seen before in a vehicle. Brake hold is, this only works now if you have your foot on the brake, you're in drive, and you're just sitting there, but you have to have your seatbelt on as well. If you don't have your seatbelt on, not going to work. You're sitting in traffic, and you're sitting there holding the brake. You got it in drive, and you're holding the brake, and you're like, man, my tired foot's getting tired. Well, you just push that button, and it holds it for you. You can take your foot off the brake, relax, everything, and really neat feature. And then when you're ready to go again, you just push your foot on the brake and you know, push that, and it releases it, and then you're good to go. Of course, you can always put it in park or neutral and stuff like that, but I think that's neat to have that brake hold feature. All right, so here is the cup holders. Now they're really deep cup holders, and I don't know if you can see in there good. They're really deep, but that's for like the big tall glasses. But if you need to, you just have a normal size coffee cup, you can fold these down and it turns into a normal size coffee holder or something. So pretty cool, you do have the ability to do that. change the the depth of the cup holder. All right, so here is the center console. This actually moves, this armrest, so you can move it back and forth. And this lifts up, and you got some little tiny storage pockets here that you can put some stuff in there. I like the way they don't put it too big because, you know, it always gets cluttered and you can't find stuff. Up here is an auto dim rear view mirror, and you can turn that feature on and off. It does have a light sensor that will, at nighttime, you know, dim it down so then all the lights don't blind you while you're driving. There's that button there. And up here we have some tap lights so you can get a quick reading light. And right here is for, you should see if I can show you this. All right, so your interior lights, you can have them to where they open when you, this position, it will only when the door's open, all the lights will turn on. But if you don't want that to turn on, you just put it off like that. And that way, even if you open up the doors, it will not turn the lights on. And then here is for your sunroof. So there's your sunroof. There's the has a shade over it now. Move that back manually. And let's go ahead and tilt it up so you can see there. Put it down. Let's go ahead and open it up all the way so you can see how far it goes. And we can close it. And it's a pretty hot day today, and on days like that, I like to close the shade so the light doesn't shine on me. All right, let's take a look at the visibility back here. Really, really neat vehicle. I am super impressed, and I would jump all over this if I was in the market for a vehicle like this. All right, so let me know what you think. If there's anything that, you know, I wasn't clear on, if I got something wrong, or if you have any experience with this vehicle, let's say you bought one already somehow and you're already driving it, or if you've test driven one, you know, let me know your experience in the comments. Anything that you liked or anything, just please share. I'd really appreciate it. And if you can subscribe to my channel, share the videos. I'm at East Coast Honda, and this is a dealership that I've really wanted to work with for some time now. And so I got, you know, talking with John Vincent. He's a really cool guy, really easygoing, and I'm going to leave his contact information in the description so you can contact him. He can literally deliver these vehicles to you anywhere in the United States. You just send him an email and it's done. I mean, he like handle everything. So you don't have to think about it. You just pick out what you want. Just tell him what you want and he'll make it happen. So anyways, thank you for watching. Thank you, East Coast Honda, for allowing me to show off this awesome car. And I will see you guys later. Thanks.